the start of a journey to save civilian lives. Near the Belgian town of Ostend, this plane chartered by the European Union is being loaded up with boxes bearing food and health supplies like syringes and medicine, all bound for the people of Gaza. The EU says it wants to send them a message.
We are not forgetting you. We will be there to help you. We will be there to help you. You can count on the European Union. European Union has been assisting, providing humanitarian assistance to Palestinian people since the year 2000 and will shall continue to do so as long as necessary.
This EU-backed delivery is the eighth of its kind in the last few weeks, sent to local humanitarian staff on the ground.
From here in Belgium, that plane will then fly several hours toward Egypt. The Egyptian Red Crescent will then come to collect all those key supplies that are on board.
But how soon will this aid make it to ordinary Gazans? Humanitarian access to the besieged territory is still severely limited, and aid workers say that has to change.
Nothing is good if it sits in a warehouse, in an emergency response. It needs to go immediately to the affected population. This is why our collective call is unhindered and continuous access to the population within Gaza to ensure they can get what they need at the time that they need it.
Colleagues are there on the ground. What are they telling you about their experience?
It's terrifying. The reality is we've got volunteers from the Palestinian Red Crescent Society each morning who are working in the ambulance shifts and telling each other goodbye because they don't know if they're going to be able to come back.
The EU has more than tripled its humanitarian aid funding for Palestinians and says there is no evidence this support is being used by terror group Hamas. More humanitarian air bridge flights are planned, but with the situation for civilians in Gaza described as dire, it's a race against time to reach people waiting on the other side.